probably about me,
but they were trying to like diss G-Con in the process. Basically, well, why do you hang out with a white supremacist? That kind of stuff is what they're saying.
Oh, why does G-Con hang out with a white supremacist? Because people can see, Volcavit, you are a white supremacist.
Kind of out of nowhere.
So why do they call you a white supremacist?
My understand, it's like this. If you're not considered black by the Hebrew Israelites, then that's what they've got for you. You're a racist or a supremacist. If you are black or brown.
Okay. So what he's saying is, we're saying that if you're not black or Hispanic, you're an instantaneous white supremacist. When have we ever said that? The Hamites are white supremacists. The Moabite is a white supremacist. What sense do that make, right?
Then they call you a sellout, such as the C-O-O-N word. Or if you're Native American, they call you Uncle Tomahawk.
Yeah, we will call you that. That's true.
Or if you're Mexican, they call you Mexico. These are terms.
Why did you? They said you're the C. They call you the C-O-O-N word. But then he says and then says the goddamn word.
Mexicoon. You see that? You see what he does to the Mexican brother? Mexicoon.
Well, you know why he doesn't like Mexican people, right?
No.
Okay, all right.
But we know why he don't like Mexicans, though. Because his girl do. Well, we just gonna keep this rolling. His girl like Mexican brothers. So he does not like Mexicans.
Come on now, Deacon. Let me tell you something, right?
I got a right. My mom's brother, right? My so-called uncle. Now, he became a racist against blacks, right? And he told my mom, he was drinking with my mom one night when she was younger. And she said, you know why? He said, because my wife left me for a black man. So for the same reason vocab don't like Mexicans, is why he'll say Mexicoon, right? It's because, of course, we know he had a situation with a woman, and now she's with a brother named Jose. All right? This is fact. And now she's with a brother named Jose. 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 All right, this is fact. Am I lying about Jose?
Look at your top on you.
Your dog is the one that discovered about Jose. He said, wait, this girl was with vocab, but now I see her with a brother named Jose. What happened? Jose, you know, he and that's Jose's woman now, right? So, of course, he'll say a racial epithet towards Mexicans because he's got that special hatred.
So, what is your beef? Why did you feel as though you wanted to talk about the Israelites?
Well, my main focus before that in apologetics was Islam. So I was dealing with Salafi Islam, which is a very serious global reality, you know?
Into these guys on the blocks. Do you hear this dude? So he told me, here's the thing that he's telling. He's lying to Solomon. He's a liar. The man looked me in the eye and told me that his boy got his church taken over by Hebrew Israelites, and that's what started him on this whole journey. After knowing right where they were and going and finding them, what video do we see of Volcab Malone just in the streets evangelizing people? The nigga ain't in the streets.
You're not in the streets like that.
You're not in the streets like that. Are you kidding me? I'm running into him on the blocks. Who knows about that new face mask Volcab Malone puts out to get in the way? He wants to get black people murdered, right? Y'all know Volcab Malone is selling a COVID mask? I'm going to show it to you, and you're going to take one look at that, and you're going to understand that Volcab Malone wants black people to die. I'm going to show it to you right now. Watch it. Take a look at that. It's a red bandana. To hell with what it says. It is a red bandana. before this true fight, if I would have seen a nigga walking down the street with this face mask on, brother, I ain't even talking to him.
No, see what I'm saying? It's a Christian thing.
Mask. Bro, how?
I want to give all the praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shah Bahashem, Recha HaKodash, and double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone. Shalom. Peace to the elect nation of Israel scattered abroad. Okay, I want to touch on this video with Vocab. It was inspired by Apostle Tahar's video, GMS DocuTube, the one he did on Vocab. And I went into the research and found out it came from Sakari. It wasn't hard to figure out. And then, hey, it says it all. Now we understand the hatred that Vocab Malone has. he's very upset. And rightfully so, in a sense. On the left-hand side, he should be upset. You know, his kingdom is fallen. There's a new wave of biblical scriptures than before. You know, there's a new day coming, and that day will become darkness for Edom. Okay, and it will be brightness for the Israelites. Okay, so we can understand. I don't have much to say. We now understand the hatred, and this goes back to Jacob and Esau, but even fast forwarding how they hated us because of what we were and who we were. That's much hatred. When you start off and you're in a relationship, and then you're losing your partner to these so-called blacks and natives, you know, it would really, really upset you. We can see that pain in Vocab's eyes. It's understandable now. So going into the debate, I don't have much to say. You know, I'm just going to touch on this a little bit. Going into that debate, I listened to a little Apostle Hart channel, and I was saying that in a video as well. That wasn't even a debate. He came up in trickery, right? Because if it was, he already knows that Great Millstone don't go out and do these debates. So they tricked him in a form of a falsehood, a false debate. Apostle Tahar and the apostles, Gabar and Apostle Rumlub, they was really being generous, you know, to Vocab Malone. They was really being sincere and trying to get them to, you know, at least hear the points of what we had to say. And who knows, somebody out there may see it and wake up. I mean, this is Apostle Paul said, try to convince the gainsayers. Who knows? One of them Jakes that was standing there with Vocab possibly could get it, could have got it, but he didn't. But it's also used as a tool for the internet. So now that other Israelites know that it's not so much about skin color that you'll have Israelites that awake. But this thing that Vocab did was full of trickery and slander and deceit. Okay? That's all it was. If you notice, there was not many scriptures coming out on those guys. They pulled out one, maybe two scriptures. They was just arguing. They was making a rebuttal to what was being said. That's it. There was really no scriptures coming out. Let's go to Psalm 21 and 11. It says, "For they intended evil against thee," and that's these guys. They intended evil from the beginning. When you watch the beginning of the clip, they said, "We're going to approach these GMS guys." They was not going to come there, right, and have some form of discord without creating some form of mischief, right? They wasn't going to do it. It says they imagined a mischievous device which they are not able to perform. And this is what's going to show time and time again. People are going to start seeing, you know, his followers, they all follow him anyway. I mean, if you believe in a favorite singer or dancer, nobody's better than them. Well, it's in your head. You're going to think that way. So it doesn't matter what his audience thinks. They're complete idiots anyway. I'm just being honest, because there was no edification on Vocab's behalf on the truth. their argument was, it's not even a, I guess it was an argument. It wasn't even a true debate. Okay. So we understand what's going on. Psalm 2:1. I could go on and on about it, but I just want to hit the point. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? You know, and that's what this guy has done. You know, so I don't have anything much to say. Just the fact that now we kind of have a more clearer understanding, okay, on why Vocab Malone is so mad. And it really goes back to Jacob and Esau, that blessing, that birthright. He wants it back. This is Esau fighting for the birthright. He wants it back. He's trying to maintain it. And what he's trying to take you Israelites, what he's trying to do is put you back into bondage under white Jesus. Okay? He's trying to put you back into bondage. This also proves, according to the scriptures, we all know who the biblical Israelites are. He said, we don't believe that they're Israelites. But according to the scriptures, the Israelites would be scattered amongst all nations. They wouldn't be in one place. So he doesn't want to admit in his mind who he think the biblical Israelites are. Because I've done lessons on that. Is a Jewish man who set him up. A Christian Jew. I've never heard of that, but I guess that's going on now. Set him up. So we know this is all falsehood. This is all set up. I never heard of that, but hey, the snake is trickery, you know? The snake is very trickery. The serpent is trickery. Anyway, I just want to touch on that. That's all I have on that. Shalom.